thought I got rid of you people.
Never. You're just too good to us.
You don't look like you're quite old enough to be doing that.
Well, I was Vietnam-era, but a little after the early 70s. I didn't go to Vietnam.
I was over there, but I'm not
going to go. I stuck in Guam as far as I got.
We had a boat because we were here with
him. Oh, okay. That's right, yeah.
The sailors thought we were good.
But we had a boat, but I'm going to go to the
but as we grew up, we grew smarter. The doors that he's going in there, they just don't look like we get there, so not here. The room is different. No, we use next Saturday. Every Saturday now. Look at all the poppies we got here. No, we don't have to go on. I'm going to say it for me. No, it's good fun. I was just going to be on the film. Well, we were running just the caboose and the info at 15:00.
California's afraid of wood.
The wood wouldn't be a problem these days, and we wouldn't be heating them with pot-belly stoves. We wouldn't have electrical wire that, you know, so far apart without insulation on it. Oh, George is just having a fun time showing off his trains to you folks.
I think we just missed it.
Everybody asked that. Oakdale was where we went. We started in Oakdale, came on out, went across to Angel Camp, and off to Tuolumne.
Well, I guess it is right.
Yeah. I don't know. This year had a Oh, once they go to Oakdale, you can go to the world. Oakdale will take you the rest of the country. But the difference was is you have to switch from one train to the other.
They set them out.
Because, all the train folks that own the different companies were very jealous of their press and stuff. So we couldn't take this and take you all the way back to New York. And they said, no, you don't get to run on our tracks. You'd have to switch to one of their trains. If they have trackage right, they could do it.
I bet they'd take number three.
But you'll have to have one.
They didn't take it when it got here. Yeah. It was shipped, well, of course, that was the 1800s. Number three wasn't in. It was rather new. It was only about 6 years old when it came here.
Yeah, but that, they might have actually put one of their
locomotives
in.
Mm-hmm.
Well, sure, they want to be that way.
Yeah, I was telling gentlemen earlier, that's the original boiler room in number three.
Oh, really?
Yeah, that's what it looks like underneath this. This is all mostly a facade covering up the work.
Yep.
And that's what it looks like underneath.
So,
are you
going to come back to the future?
Mm-hmm. Yep. Back to the
future. Because that long rail on the side,
this is the train.
This is the train.
Now they used a different smoke stack on it.
Yeah.
And if you could,
you can see,
I have a feeling
to
look up. You can see the smoke stack that they used
in the
gallery over there. You can see where they blew it apart. You can see the original. You can see when they blew apart.
Oh, wow,
I just bought the set of tapes they had in there, about Canadian quality.
Yeah.
And that was pretty good. I got to see that one. I haven't seen the rest of them yet. It was all about steam engines.
Yeah.
And where I work, I have working with adults with disabilities. I had a situation where I do what's called men's group.
Yeah.
And we talk about men. But I showed them that picture.
And they did. Yeah. I said, that's the man who's got over all the things.
Restoration to the number three is the pilot for that series.
Really?
Yeah, it is phenomenal. I've seen the pilot. I think they're going to debut it over in Europe sometime.
Mm-hmm.
And if they can sell it there, they might be able to sell it here. See, some of these shows that they sell over here, it was done really well.
How much did the restoration of number three cost?
$1.4 million. Some people will give you as much as $1.7 million. It depends upon where they rent it at. Thank you.